This video has been created thanks to MyWorld, a consortium programme fueling the West of England's creative technology sector and funded by UK Research and Innovation Strength in Places Fund. This video will guide you through how to build the ARRI Alexa Mini LF. The ARRI Alexa Mini LF combines the compact size of the Alexa Mini with the Alexa LF sensor. It includes an LPL lens mount with L-bus connector, a PL to LPL adapter, and can record large format or Super 35. It uses ARRI RAW and Apple ProRes recording formats, can capture 14 plus stops of dynamic range, and uses the codec's compact drive 1TB recording media. It also features three internal full-spectrum neutral density filters, two built-in microphones, an additional external Wi-Fi antenna, and comes with the multi-viewfinder MVF2, which includes an OLED display with a 4-inch flip-out LCD monitor. In order to attach the shoulder pad to the camera body, unlock the compact bridge plate. Slide the shoulder pad onto the plate and lock into position. Slide the camera onto the tripod dovetail plate and lock into place. Attach the mini side bracket MSB3 to the left-hand side of the camera and tighten the four captive screws using the Allen key. Rotate the camera and attach the mini side bracket MSB2 to the right-hand side of the camera and tighten the four screws. Insert the short 19mm rod into the side bracket and lock into position. Slide the mini viewfinder bracket into the mini adapter plate and lock the rods into position. In order to attach the viewfinder, unlock the lever. Slide it onto the viewfinder bracket and lock into place. To adjust the viewfinder position, unlock the top wing nut lever and move it into the desired position. You can also rotate the viewfinder by adjusting the viewfinder bracket. Attach one end of the viewfinder cable to the back of the viewfinder and the other end to the VF port on the left-hand side of the camera. On the center camera handle, there are four captive screws that will attach to the mini adapter plate. Use the Allen key to tighten the screws. Connect the antenna to the camera. There are different ways to adjust the monitor mount to rotate, pan, and tilt in order to find your desired position. Once ready, attach to one of the 3/8 thread inserts on the rear accessory bracket. Screw the mount to the base of the monitor. Attach the Sunhood brackets to the monitor using the screws provided and tighten the screws with the Allen key. Make sure the holes are facing the front of the monitor. Attach the Sunhood to the monitor brackets. Connect the SDI cable to the SDI 1 port on the back of the camera and the other end to the SDI in port on the back of the monitor. Unlock the clamp attached to the V-mount power splitting box. Slide the box onto the rear accessory bracket and lock into position. Connect the power splitting box 8-pin LiMo cable to the BAT port on the back of the camera. To power the monitor, attach the D-tap end of the cable into the side of the power splitting box and the 2-pin LiMo to the base of the monitor, ensuring the red dots align. Insert the 19mm rods and lock into position. Place the lens support onto the rods and lock into place. Turn the lens mount retaining ring to the left and release the cap. Insert the lens, making sure the pins and screws are aligned. Rotate the lens mount retaining ring to the right to secure the lens. Support the weight of the lens by hand and adjust the lens support into position. tighten the screws and lock into place. Attach the V-lock battery, making sure the pins are facing down and the V is in the correct position. Open the media card slot and insert the memory card. Switch the camera on and you're ready to start filming.